Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Wasteland 3, and now we are continuing on from the last thing. We were in the church here, we talked to Gideon Reyes, and we talked to this wonderful lady over here, Miriam Knox, who has a husband that has been kidnapped by Vic Buchanan, I believe, and we will go and take care of that quest much later on, but at the moment, let's go ahead and continue this little playthrough here. We do have a little quest right up here. Just go and save it. So we'll have Lucia just go and talk to this person. We'll just talk to her.
Please step back, Rangers. I'm not supposed to let anyone near this servitor drone. It's malfunctioning something fierce, and we think it belonged to the Wessons.
All right, we take a look, a closer look. Lucia, you're Wesson. Doesn't that make the drone your property? That's what we're going to choose.
That's right. I recognize that drone. It ran little errands for my father and alphabetized his books.
Are you going to stop Miss Wessing from accessing her property?
No, I mean, no, ma'am. Please, don't mind me. Go ahead and do whatever you need to do.
As far as you can tell, the drone is stuck in some sort of loop. Its chassis is banged up, so the damage may have led to an internal fault. We do have nerd stuff up, so luckily, we can go and get this sucker fixed. If the robot's operating system crashes, it might initiate a reboot sequence. It might be possible to rewire the server to a bot without shutting it off. That would allow you to force a system restart, in theory. We're going to do nerd stuff. We're going to hard crash the drone's brain so it reboots. Ooh. Locate hidden treasure. That's what we're going to do. We're going to follow this guy, and he's going to head back to Lucia's old residence, and as you can see in his code there, locate hidden treasure.
So they killed the Wessons, the Shulers, the Jacksons.
Unfortunately, it takes forever. I mean, I suppose I can just go up ahead, right?
Patriarchs at the doors.
Poor Lucia.
This is the direction he's going right here, by the way. And it kind of swings the camera around because it's going to tell you where the treasure's going to be at. I wonder if we can see it with our awareness. So we can't see it with our awareness. This is one that the robot will actually have to pinpoint. Come along, robot. Sorry, we're all in your way. There it is. Let's go pick up this hidden treasure. What goodies do we have? Oh, well, we have an army MG. This is really nice. We are going to keep this. This 50 cal ammo is really expensive and really hard to find, though, so it's not going to become our primary heavy machine gun for Princess Hell, but we are going to keep it because things. We got an advanced armor mod piece. That's really nice right there, that plasma capsule. We need someone with an armor modding of 5, and I think that is Thorgrim. Or Thorgrim's doing weapon modding, and I think Lucia's doing armor modding. I can't remember one of those, but this is another armor mod. So, yeah, that's a good find. I think what you get in there is random, other than that gun. That gun's not random. Everything else is. All right, so this is Lucia's home. She's going to cry a bit about her family being slaughtered by her stalker-like boyfriend that we totally annihilated. All right, here we go.
It feels so empty now. Even when Pa and Ma were traveling, they were here. Their spirits filled the place.
And blah, blah, blah. Okay, so we need a lockpicking of 6 to get in there. What we're looking at with Corpse, our expert lockpicker. How many we got? We have only 4 in lockpicking, and that stinks. We need to get at least 2 more. And it's going to cost a total of 5 to get it up 2 more, so we can't do that exactly just yet. We should make a note to come back here, and we probably will. But let's see if there's anything else to loot in this immediate area. There isn't, but over here there is a container.
Mama used to love sitting in here. She'd be ashamed of the mess it's in.
Look behind here.
Damn Dorseys weren't content to rip everything up. They had to toss the furniture around too. Animals couldn't even leave my memories of this place alone.
Lucia, what do you think happened here?
My house was the first place the Dorseys went. Probably walked right in through the front door, stole my parents and little brother away, and then took out their anger on the house.
Peer beyond the rubble. It's dark, but you can make out smashed scraps of wood and splintered doors. It doesn't look like the attackers left much of anything behind.
No point looking back there. It's smashed up even worse, and the Dorseys took everything worth stealing.
Yeah. They didn't take everything, obviously. This is here, and this is here, and there's going to be some more stuff up around here. So let's go ahead and get everyone. We have some things we can open here, and we can't open this one, unfortunately, just yet. Another thing we'll have to come back to once Corpse's lockpicking is back up.
She'd be ashamed of
kind of standard stuff. And we'll lockpick this. Ice axe. Nothing we can really use. We do have to upgrade Thorgrim's weapon, by the way. Something we need to do before we take off into the Colorado Waste. Let's go and disarm this.
Wow. Daddy really didn't want any Dorseys to muck around with his cooking supplies.
Can we disarm this, please? That's the extra 16 XP. Now, this place is still wired. There's something there. There's something there. And, let's come in just a little bit more. Another trap. Oh, hold on, guys. Oh, my God. Okay, hold on. Get out of here. All of you. It's dangerous. Let Corpse handle this. Actually, don't let Corpse handle this. Corpse, get out of here. Princess L, come back. And we'll go ahead and do a quick save, and now we need to go and disarm this stuff. So her father really booby-trapped this area up. I can't disarm this, unfortunately. And try to maneuver a way around it, and then we'll go and disarm this. Let's see what's in here first. Money. Junk. We do have a toaster that can be repaired. Let's check Lucia real quick. Lucia is our toaster repair guru. She's got a toaster repair of 3, but if we put on this mask, she'll now have a toaster repair of 4. So let's get Lucia in here. Come in here, please, my darling. Repair that. Bingo! Gold insulated power cord, a rubberized cable infused with gold that could carry power from an outlet to a toaster. Price $1,000. Wow. Okay, that's just nice loot. Let's get Lucia around here. I don't think there's any other traps besides this one. Maybe I'm pretty sure we can just walk around this. And there's our last bit of junk. Take a quick look. There's nothing it seems like be affected. Yeah, there's nothing else that we can loot in here, but we did get some good stuff, so. I'm very pleased with that. Out we go. So we know we have 2 things we have to open up in this room. We have this container, which requires a lockpick of 5, and we have this requires a lockpick of 6. So just make a note of that. We'll come on out here into the open. Yeah, do a little back up. And come into the main square here. There should be some things that we can loot. Just a statue. Isaiah Buchanan passes the flag of the United States of America to his son, the future patriarch of Colorado, Saul Buchanan, calling upon him to protect and glorify it to the end of his days. Fascinating. All right, when you come into this park area here in Broadmoor Heights, make sure you kind of come around to the side here because you're going to find hidden items. This is one of them. We got that, yeah, got some nice junk. Should be some more stuff here. There's this bust. There's this little pile here we can dig through. Robots and rangers for real.
You descend the narrow stairs and find the door to the bunker slightly ajar.
I listen at the door.
Make a perception roll. It's awful dark out here.
We should go inside.
This was your idea. You said it would be cool to play a game in the park.
I got a 15! Do I hear anything?
You hear a faint scraping sound inside. Like the sound of a skeletal foot dragging across stone. It's coming closer.
Did you hear that?
It's just the wind.
Ah! A pale dog! There's a pale dog watching us!
What? Where? I don't see...
It's coming after us! Run!
That's great. Okay, so we did dig up this ancient love letter. My dearest, I have left a puzzle for you as you test... For you, as a test of our bond, this is the first of three special locations within this park. Today is Sunday. I'm counting the days until we are together again. Alright, so this is kind of like a little mini quest in the area. And we will be able to find these items. Now, these are snowballs you can pick up, you can pee on, use. It's not what we're looking for. This grave is actually not what we're looking for either. It just says LB. What we need to find is a tree. And here's the tree. Now, you can find this stuff just by holding down left shift. All right, a plaque on this tree says, planted on the day of the patriarch's birth, Tuesday, April 18th, 2028. This may be one of the three locations mentioned in the ancient love letter. Examine the tree carefully, you find a box that is somewhat concealed in the trunk. The wood has grown around it, but a tiny keyhole is visible through a crack in the wood. Okay, we don't have enough to break into there, but one of the other clues is right here at this bench. So let's go over this bench. Inscription on the bench reads, for Camilla, the cleverest girl I met on a Monday, noting the reference to a day of the week, like in the ancient love letter, you searched the area. Wedged underneath the bench, you find a small, ornate key. It looks like it's been there for a long time. Let's head back to the street. Alright, examine the tree. Okay, we got it. You use the key found on the bench. And we get a pelt of proposal. The box is bigger than it looks. You pull out a tightly rolled bearskin and rolling in it, you discover what happens to be an ancient and undelivered marriage proposal along with quite a lot of money. So we got 200 bucks and some kind of pelt.
I reckon it's a good thing this proposal was never delivered.
Ah, young love. Glad I grew out of it.
All right, we get to see this in any inventory. It's weird how some things just don't show up in your inventory. It just kind of automatically comes there. So, arrives there, or it's like in the background, sits in the background. So it doesn't show it on here, but that's fine. Got 200 bucks and whatever that pelt does. I think it does some kind of bonuses, but I'm not sure what kind of bonuses. We're going to go around here, see if we can find anything. We can't get in there. And there's nothing really... left. If you go up here, you're going to find the entrance to the patriarch.
I'm gonna live like this.
There's a lot of elite guards around here. You see, there's nothing really left to lose. If we go farther in here, they're going to stop us. We're not going to be able to get through. And, yeah. Alright, let's head down this way. We can't break into here. Again, it requires the lockpick of 6. Probably that robot will attack us too if we try to get in there. Alright, well, I think we are done with Broadmoor Heights for right now. So let's go ahead and head out, and we will go ahead and... We'll go ahead and get that upgrade for Thorgrim first, and then we will head outside into Denver proper. And so I'll see you back at Ranger HQ real quick.
Man, I miss Vegas! Hey, it's the Rangers! Let me show you.
Okay, guys, we are back at Ranger HQ, and we're going to pick up this jackknife for Thorgrim. Let's see here. It's a great weapon, a lot better penetration. It has the lower base hit chance, but not by much. It's only like a 3% decrease. And we're gonna mod this to give us a little bit better, but it's cost only $410. Let's sell the junk that we have, and then we'll go and pick this up. Actually, let's go ahead and sell this. Sell this. And we're going to keep all the rest of that stuff. Okay. And there we go. Hi, please. Perfect. Let's take a look at this in our inventory. And we will go ahead and equip this weapon. There we go. I guess we can put this roadside cleaver in our secondary, and we can just have that knife on the side. And let's go ahead and modify it. This will increase our hit chance by 3%, which is pretty nice. And that'll get us our hit chance back up to where it was when we had the other weapon. So really nothing's changed other than it's got a higher penetration and it's got a higher damage output. So yes, please. That's been modified. I think we are good to go. And we just got to check. Sweetie's got her mods. She doesn't need a bigger magazine size. I think everyone else will be fine. Let's go ahead over to the docks. Let's get everyone healed up. I know it's really just Thorgrim who needs it.
What do you need, Rangers? I'll do what I can. Have a seat.
All right, and we are all nice and healed up.
I don't mind not having to clean and suture a festering wound.
All right, and probably one of the last things we'll do here before we head out. Actually, we should head into the garage. So I was thinking, oh, I forgot to pick up that thing. I don't know why I missed this. Cool, quick slot item is a set, requires a mechanics of 7. That's nice. We got another pulse rifle, damage sensor. Let's go ahead and get Lucia's stats raised. And Lucia probably needs another point in weapon modding. Would be nice. Twister repair, we're kind of fine with that. Might want to get another point into barter, which would help a lot. Kind of wish I got that before we went and bought that jackknife, but it is what it is. Yeah. Yeah, let's go ahead and pump up barter. And then in attributes, we'll give her another point in coordination. Should be good. And we need to switch out her mask to this. I'm going to turn that off, actually. That stupid hat that she's wearing. All right. Okay, I think we're ready and raring to go. We're going to take on off and head into Denver proper. Guys, this has been a short episode. I know it has, and I promised there'd be a fight in this one, but there hasn't been. I've lied to you too much now. I apologize. Next episode, get ready for a fight. Thanks for joining me.